Hello there guys, Qwerty Afro here, bringing you my first ever actual proper official video of Train Simulator 2015 of a scenario. Obviously the first video was the impression ones, I hope you enjoyed that. We are going to keep it very non-ranty, because people were saying that I was ranting a lot in that video. Well, it was a kind of rant, and the ranting is pretty much now over. I have nothing really much else to say. It was kind of a thing of me just leading up to the release of this game that I was kind of upset about, but now that it's released, there's no point of me just wasting my time and just talking about bad things. As I said, wait till next year. That's apparently when the kind of biggest change is going to come to the franchise. So let's just go back to normal. We're just going to be making videos of just, you know, some nice happy commentary. But also, we're going to be seeing in this video, because it is the ECML, ECML, these were one of the free routes, which were the only only routes that actually got upgraded with the new features they promised in like an article back when they said what's coming new for Train Simulator 2015, which I think is really just horrible how they actually lied to us, saying that they presented all these kind of nice new features, and then they didn't mention that it was only for free routes. So anyone new, who's new to Train Simulator, who buys Train Simulator 2015, will buy Train Simulator with those free nice routes that have been apparently improved with those new features. But then once they start buying DLC, they're going to be kind of tricked into, you know, buying really worse off quality DLC because they've only improved free routes. But anyway, enough of that. I don't want to talk about it. Let's have a look at how in this video how the kind of new changes, like the weather. I can already see the sky looks a bit more pretty, and we'll see the passengers as well. But shoutouts for this video go to iScienceAlexP and Ozcan Ekici. Yeah, I'm guessing that's how you say it. So that's again iScienceAlexP and Ozcan Ekici. Their links and stuff will be down below. Give them some love to their channels. Those are the shoutouts. So, we're doing this scenario. I think it's the shortest scenario for the Class 801. I might do them. Might do the two other ones in the future. But, again, we're in the Class 801, the newest train to kind of come with Train Simulator 2015, the kind of like new kind of concept train that they've been like, you know, pushing forward, like as they have like some partnership with Hitachi and they just want to show off this concept train. So anyway, this is the scenario. Let's start. So, good morning, driver. Following a delay whilst preparing the train, you are now running slightly late. You will need to proceed to King's Cross as quickly as possible due to your departure of 5:50. Okay. So, let me just set up. Let's just put the headlights on like that. I don't think there's anything else we need to do. I think everything is pretty much done for me. But drive, obviously, I like how they've actually put some. Have they put some, no? In the kind of zooming out thing of the beginning of the video, I saw some old trains. Okay, good. That's cool. I like that, old and new trains together. That's really cool. But anyway, let's just get on what we have to do. We obviously have to get this train to King's Cross, and I think then we're doing a service to Stevenage. Stevenage? Whatever, I can't pronounce it. This is similar to the scenario that I did before. It was in the Class 90 I did it in, where it was more towards the end of the video. So I'm kind of doing the kind of beginning of the video where we do it like from here to King's Cross and then out back out. So it's gonna be pretty cool. So let's go for it. Let's see this train now. Give it we have some AI coming by, which is pretty cool as well. Oh, actually quite a lot of AI. And are these the look, these are the new passenger animations and stuff. Oh my god, they actually did it, sort of. Let's have a look here. They're actually doing stuff, and apparently everyone has a mobile, which is great. That's okay. I'm happy. That's cool. I like that. It's nothing special. Oh, by the way, are there... Okay, there are no passengers in here. So this is apparently the thing that they also, like... Oh. Really? Oh, I hate this so much. Oh, good. It wasn't the alarm. I thought it was the alarm. But yeah, the there's, if you can tell, in the actual train I'm driving, there are actually no passengers inside the train, because obviously this was a change that I don't know why it wasn't implemented in earlier, that there are actually supposed to be no passengers when the train is coming out of the depot. So that's something they fixed. I'm happy they fixed it. That's really nice. It makes it a bit more authentic. So now I'm like shunting my train from the depot to the station. That's all good. I'm very happy with that. What is that noise? It's like a scuffling noise. I don't know what it is. We're gonna be kind of racing with this class 365. That'd be pretty cool. But I think the class 365 is gonna be ahead a bit. The FPS is gonna go slightly low, obviously, because we're in an area full AI traffic or whatever. But you know. Oh, I think, I'm doing a career scenario right now, but I think I've turned off the scoring. Well, I don't know. I don't know how it works. I'm definitely doing a career scenario right now, but I'm kind of surprised that it hasn't scored me yet or whatever. I'm not too sure. It doesn't matter. As I said, in my opinion, I don't really care about career scenarios too much. Oh, wow, nice. Oh, look at that. Getting overtaken. Let's speed up. Let's speed up because we can. We have 60 miles an hour. Let's go. Let's beat this class 365. Like, I can literally smoke this in a straight line. But we're beating you. I don't give it. Oh, but we're reaching our max speed now. Which is a bit annoying. And the game is laggy, but you know. That's what you get when you have loads of AI, which is good. I like AI. It's a good sign. Look at her go. That's nice. But anyway, yeah, soon, I've been reading some of the comments, and yeah, this train will be basically soon replacing loads of, like, stuff on, basically diesel trains are right now, like, the HSTs and stuff like that. They'll be replacing those. It's sad, because I like the HSTs. The HSTs are really cool trains, and this train's not really anything, I don't think it's anything exciting to look forward to, but you know, it's cool. It's fresh. It is a descendant of the Javelin, let's be honest. It's not anything different. It is pretty much a descendant of a Javelin. It has a more simplistic cab, because obviously it's not doing the high speed kind of part that the Javelin probably can outpace it. Let's be honest, because the Javelin is built to be a high-speed train, like a proper high-speed train. And this is probably built to kind of do the kind of, maybe even 10 or 20 miles an hour more faster than the actual HSDs and whatever, so that's why they're not going to be anything special or whatever. Oh, you have to stop here. Well, we're going to just quickly swoosh by. Something else I'm noticing a little bit different, I don't know if it's on this map, the kind of saturation of colours look a little different. It looks or the contrast maybe, I don't know. I think it's the saturation of colours. They look a little bit fuller. The colours look a little bit fuller for me. I don't know why, but it does look a little more richer in colour. I don't know if because the thing, what I've always kind of tend to have with Train Simulator is when you kind of play most of the maps and stuff, it does look... Oh, we need to slow down. I didn't even see the 40 miles an hour kind of thing. It doesn't matter. At least it doesn't annoyingly pop up with a score. I think I disabled the scoring. It doesn't matter. Anyway, we're back up to 65. But yeah, in Train Simulator before, like, it just, when you load into some of these, like, maps and stuff, they kind of look a little bit washed out and dreary. So, in a way, it is nice that they've kind of brightened up the colours a bit. because I'm definitely noticing. Because when I've played this map, especially like on this approach and whatever, it does look a bit dreary, and this actually looks pretty impressive. Actually, I love the actual colors that they've actually added already. Because obviously, with these free maps that come with Train Simulator 2015, they obviously had to spice them up a bit and make them like more presentable for new users. So I'm guessing that they just took this map and the two others, New York to New Haven and the other German map I can't remember the name of, and they pretty much maybe just redid it in some ways. They kind of retextured it, recolored it, done up the new animations for the passengers, the weather and stuff like that. And in some ways then, I kind of understand maybe why they didn't do it on every single map, but I don't know. I just kind of feel let down that all the other maps are basically the same, and it just feels like that they've been just left on the side while these three maps just got some, you know, first class treatment. That's annoying. Like, I really wish it. Why the East Coast Main Line? Like, I would have rather wanted maybe even London to Faversham, even the Great East Main Line. I would have preferred over this. Once arrived at King's Cross, release the doors to allow passengers to board before changing gangs for the journey north. No problem. But we do have to slow down though. Yeah, I would have liked, like what about the Portsmouth Direct Line? These kind of older routes that would love to have like this kind of revamp done. It would have been cool. But to be honest, I'm satisfied. I'm gonna continue playing the game. I wanna turn on the desk illumination. Yep, there we go. That does it. We can put on the reading light if we want to. Just right now while we're in the tunnel. There is a train leaving. There's also another Class 801 there. Already. A shame that there's not more trains, because normally King's Cross is a really, really busy station. It only at night you'd probably see this kind of, you know, this kind of like emptiness, but I'm kind of a bit surprised that it's not fuller with AI, and this is a standard AI for the game, where the there's actually more down here, you just can't see it. Now let's get this train into this platform and let's get our schedule to, Stevenage. I think that train might be going. Look, you have some guys with headphones. Okay, so I don't get why they couldn't actually add this to all the other maps. Like, at least the passengers. Like, I don't mind maybe the weather might have been a bit too difficult. Even the weather, why can't you just add it as like some kind of code or algorithm or whatever for every single map? I just don't get that. Right, let's do a nice posing finish. Oh, that whining sound, it just sounds really not nice. There we go. And what's this with people just popping out even before the doors opening? That's just really odd. Okay, let's just close everything on this side. We don't need anything here. We'll change the lights when we get to the other side. There we go. Perfect. Headlights. There we go. Headlights on. Desk illumination on. We don't need the thing light because I can see properly. That is all good. I'm happy with that. Go exploring a bit. Yeah, stuff has changed. Just the whole kind of color, as I said, the color is the main thing that I'm noticing right now. The color is definitely much more improved. It looks more fuller. It almost looks a bit like cartoony, but in a good way. I'm definitely happy with this kind of artistic style. I don't know, because I definitely do notice it. Oh. Hello there. Class 365 AI. With still the open doors issue. Like, this... I don't get why this hasn't been rectified. Like, I had people commenting on, like, why do I complain so much or whatever. Well, okay. Just look at this. I'm not going to complain. I've already complained about it, but just look at this. This is a simulator. And this is, like, a real major bug. And especially even with one of these free maps that have gotten all the kind of major updates that they promised, why is this an actual issue still? Why are the doors open? I don't know, I'm not even going to bother look at it. Like, that's just really crazy. But yeah, I don't know. Both that'd be cool. Let's go and have a look at the both doors are open. But anyway, let's look at my train. My train's more important. Would have been also cool if we if the destination boards changed. Like, why can they input that? That would have been nice. That would have been really, really cool. Right. Maybe, will this train go before us? It'd be cool if it did. No, it's not. It's got a red light. But it is a pretty long train, actually. Gotta give it that. It is a very nice long train. And I'm hearing this scuffling sound. I don't know if that's the wind. Got a nice passenger view, which I did in the first impressions video. It's not bad. It is a nice passenger view, definitely. Okay, we've got that message. I get that. Almost ready to go. King's Cross. Definitely got a good, nice revamp. Destination boards, still nothing to say about them. Let's get ready to go, guys. We're off to Stevenage with a 9 coach class 801. Let's go. And again, this annoying horn. But imagine this. This will be soon the site here. This will be soon what everyone will be going on from King's Cross if you're going to go on like a high-speed train. Well, it won't be in white. Obviously, it'll be in like an East Coast livery or something like that. Well, maybe they will be in white. Maybe when they test it, they'll just leave it in white before they decide to put the livery on. Don't know. So right here, we might be seeing the actual future of what actual future events might happen. But there it goes, silently off into the distance. And there's a crane over there. Just being a crane. Crane simulator? No. Right. Oh, I just got there in time to do the alarm. Now the long 15-mile-an-hour crawl. No image expected here. Why is it always constantly on? That should be taken off. Like, I get that when I open the doors, when you put that jokey image there, but it would be cool if they actually did this up so you can actually have a look at the outside. It puts a screen of what's happening on the outside. But again, this is something I would think for Train Simulator 2016, where obviously the graphic engine would be able to handle this sort of stuff, where you'd be able to actually watch on monitors like what's happening elsewhere in game or whatever. And that's why I'm expecting much more detail as well. Another class 365 coming back from who knows where. Hitchin, Peterborough even, maybe. Oh no, it's not in service. Did it say not in service? Oh, I can't look out the train. All the train has to be outside the tunnel if I want to look at it. But I thought it said not in service. Or maybe it didn't say. Or maybe it's just turned its blind down now or something like that. I don't know. But anyway, we are off. I don't know what our next station is en route. We'll have a look. Oh, wrong button. Oh, we're just going past. Oh, we're just going straight to Stevenage. Okay. Another 801 buddy there. But yeah, it's good. And also, new game coming out soon. Or actually today when I'm recording it, this video, a new game's coming out. Trans Ocean, the shipping company. That's definitely something I want to start making videos of. If you haven't checked it out, just search up Trans Ocean, the shipping company, and I definitely want to start making videos on that because I definitely want to get into the ship simulator genre. And I've already talked to you guys about like what new games are coming. There's also like European Ship Simulator, but that's kind of been delayed a bit because it's coming out on early access. But this other one, this Trans Ocean Shipping Company, is coming out, so expect a series on that because it looks pretty cool. It's a bit like Ports of Call, like a modern Ports of Call, which I can't wait for. Looks pretty good. Artistically, looks actually really nice. It is really a quiet train, I gotta give it that. It is so quiet. Doesn't make any noise. It's like a hum. It just like slivers through. It's like an actual snake. And to be honest, like trains should be compared to snakes because they pretty much are like in a definition of like what a train actually looks like. If you compare it to an animal, it does in a way look like a snake slithering through the tracks. But anyway, we're good. We're cruising up to 90 now, and then soon we'll be 95. I hope they'll give us clearance for a higher speed. That would be really nice, because I want to see what this train can do. Well, apparently here it can do 140. Oh, here it has the light, which actually shows you what the speed is. That's actually pretty cool. Does it automatically adjust to that speed? So if I go over it, like, would it go over? Or can I adjust the speed? I don't know if it's buttons or whatever. ADD, no, there's no buttons. Okay. Ooh, a little laggy. HST, good old HST. Right. What's that DRA? Okay, nothing interesting. Passing the depot here where all the class 365s are kept. While we shoot up to Potter's Bar. Oh yes, 100. We're gonna getting clearance for 100, but I don't think on this line you can go massively fast. I think this is also like one of the problems with this East Coast Main Line is the kind of speed issues that trains need to be given or do, such as when they use the class 373, the Eurostar trains basically, when they use them on this line for when it was a GNER. Great Northeastern Railway, or whatever it's called, they had problems getting past certain points. I think they could only go up to Leeds or something like that, and because past Leeds the electrical supply whatever had major issues. So maybe this train, this class 801, is probably built for the future. Probably can. Well, it's obviously gonna have to be compatible on like these lines or whatever. But it looks nice. It looks smart. It doesn't look over. You know, super futuristic. It just looks like a smart kind of, high speed train. But Well, I've been noticing it's just so quiet. It's also very responsive. It's very very quick to accelerate. And it's also, I think the brakings are good. We'll get to test out the brakings in a bit as well. But anyway, soon we're actually going to be given 115, which is great. So hopefully, maybe even 130. But I don't know how many miles it is to Stevenage, so we'll just have to see once we get past Potter's Bar. Right, let's increase the ante a bit. Also, the wiper is very good, very silent as well. One thing I hated with some trains in train simulator still is that some of the wipers have just the most annoying sound, and it almost makes you not want to put the wiper on because okay, I get sometimes maybe in real life you have the odd two train that has the annoying dodgy wiper or whatever that makes an annoying sound, but you know. Okay, this train has gas. I'm not. This train can shift. This train can shift very, very well. It is going like a stinged bat. I'm starting to just kind of like it, actually, to be honest. It's kind of growing on me. But in a way, I hate actually how you sit so far close. I wish you could sit a little bit back, because you can't really see everything around you. That's also what I found really annoying. Like say when I sit right here, it's just I'm right up into the window. I have to look down and then, you know, cut my judgment of like what's in front of me or whatever. So it's definitely not the best for cab view. I definitely think the Class 395 has a much better all-round view of the cab and the outside. But it's still nice. It is nice that I get to see a nice big view of the outside. I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I'm just, in terms of like looking at the cab and stuff, that's the only thing I'm kind of just like, could be a better field of view. Would be cool if you could actually like adjust your kind of settings and stuff like that, like in a Eurotruck where you can adjust your like seat adjustments. That would be really cool for train simulator, just so you can get comfortable in your train cab. Right, Potter's Bar. Let's just I completely went on the wrong side there. Look at it go, it's just so good. And then the boring 365, which is no longer First Capital Connect. Well, it technically is, sort of. But it's part of Govia now. Govia bought it out, and it'll be like Govia's kind of Thameslink. Govia basically renaming it back to Thameslink. So it'll be like Govia's Thameslink or something like that, I don't know. And yeah, the whole kind of Govia network is First Capital Connect and the Greater Northern services, Southeastern, Southern, and yeah, I think that is it for Govia's part. I think they might own a few more, but they're going to just basically make a huge kind of network for themselves, and it's just basically going back to nationalization. I've talked in my previous videos and stuff like about it. It's not going back to like nationalization of like of the government owning everything. It's just going back to kind of ways of nationalization of having everything under one kind of thing. But as I've kind of commented about it, it's good in terms of like a whole company can really work through like different things with like the multiple routes they own or whatever. But the thing that's going to be bad is because they own so much, they're going to monopolize the routes that they have, and they're going to easily be able to now increase fares because they're not really creating any competition with themselves if they own the three kind of major southern eastern kind of train networks in London. They basically control everything now in that kind of aspect. They can now it's crazy. But I like the thing I'm liking what they're doing with Fast Capital Connect. Obviously, they're revamping with the new trains and stuff. They're connecting they're building a new tunnel which will connect the Greater Northern services, like the services that run up here, up north where I'm now driving. They're creating a tunnel between, I think it's before King's Cross, that connects to St. Pancras. So train services can now, from Peterborough or whatever, they can now all go all the way to Brighton, essentially. Which is pretty cool. If you're like a Peterborough commuter and you want to go to Brighton or something, I don't know. But, you know, that would be pretty cool. It would be cool if they actually had some passenger animations that were like train spotters with their like tripod cameras and stuff like that. That would be really cool if, for the train enthusiast, that would be, I think, really cool. Because, you know, it would be so cool, like every other station, you might have like someone at the end of the platform recording it. Like, you know, just those kind of little touches would just, you know, those kind of little touches in a game just make it like, oh, the developers really, you know, care about that or whatever. But since I put out the first impressions video, many people are in agreement with me, and they're just saying that Dovetail Games are basically liars. In a way, they kind of tricked us into believing. Because I don't want to talk about it anymore. But the only thing that just upsets me is that why would they lie and put up that when I read the whole article of what's to come in Train Simulator 2015? Why did they put up then that all this new stuff, like the weather, like right now, even let's look at the weather. Like, I'm not really seeing any kind of difference. So the weather is pretty much the same. Like, the weather's kind of even disgraceful a bit. It's not nothing too proud to be kind of. It's the same. Maybe a little bit tightened up or whatever. I don't know. Look, yeah, the clouds. Is that clouds popping? Yeah, you have clouds popping in and out or whatever. So dynamic clouds or whatever crap they want to call it. So yeah, that might be a little bit changed, but that's not so different. The only thing I've kind of noticed is the kind of color saturation and the passenger animations. But the passenger animations aren't really anything special. They're just kind of, you know, a little bit improved. Also, the no passengers in the train out of the depot. That's just cool, I guess, that they finally realized, it's interesting that we have passengers in trains when they're going into a depot or coming out of a depot. But, you know, took them a while, but, you know, they made it, finally. Going over a nice viaduct here, do a little flyby past this train station. Whoosh! Nice. Where we are, we're in Wayland North. Passing Wayland Garden City soon. Oh, 125! But we're coming into Stevenage soon, within the next 5 miles, and that's a shame. There are the scenarios, but there's two other scenarios that come with it, so. And I've seen some scenarios also in the workshop, so I'll be trying to find some of those. Maybe to do in the future. Let's up the ante a bit more. Well, we won't be able to ante up too much, but like when we come up to like 2 miles or whatever, that's when I'll start slowing down. But for now, we can, for fun, even go full 4 and just see how fast it gets to. Oh wow, it actually climbs really well to 125. That was really quick. That's good. That's good. Top speed is good. It probably can do 140, no doubt. But that's for us to try on maybe the London to Faversham route. That would be something good to try out, even on a quick drive scenario or whatever. Just have it like on. Yeah, that'd be pretty good. If someone can do a scenario of that on the London to Faversham, like just a nice, simple, you know, little timetable journey with some AI on the London to Faversham, that'd be actually pretty rad. I'm not even gonna lie about that. Or even just a quick drive, I'd probably do. I don't know. But for now, we need to slow down. This is where we get to test out these brakes. So we are going pretty fast. I'm gonna lie, we are going pretty fast. And we've got a single yellow coming up, which is always very interesting. But we're going down pretty fast, that's good. And we're not... This nice little stress counter here on the left, it's showing that we're in comfortable terms. We're in the comfortable zone. Now, is that an actual... Yeah, it is an actual red light. Okay, are we waiting to get into a platform or something? No, Stevenage is just a normal four-bay platform. It's nothing... Okay, there we go. There we go. Single light, we got it. And we're coming into Stevenage. Coming in. An engineer at the back, maybe testing out if everything goes according to plan. Oh, I hope this the train can fit in Stevenage. It should. I think it should. It looks like it's gonna fit. Oh, we have two AR trains in there. Nice. Ladies and gentlemen, the next station is Stevenage, where this train terminates. All change, please. All change. Very nicely, and that's not over. Every time I've come into this station, I've overran. It's like a... It's a station that just haunts me. The train now approaching platform 3. Terminates here. Right. Okay, so 12 car trains can fit here, but I'm a special 9 car because this is for like the normal trains. Okay, let's back it up now. There we go. Oh, what a nice snug fit. What a very nice snug fit. This is Stevenage, where this train terminates. All change, please. All change. Am I hearing this? I think this is wind or something. I don't know what, but... I'm hearing... No, it's probably road traffic or whatever. I don't know. Stevenage, what's in here? Is this like the kitchen area or something? Oh, wow. Nothing's in here, it's all invisible. But here it's fine. I don't know, that's probably a staff area or something, so... It's out of bounds. Not even in the game we can go in it. Welcome to Stevenage! Don't know anything about Stevenage. Has a very nice red brick station concourse. That's all I know. And it has a cool waiting room. Well done, driver. You have managed to complete all of your tasks successfully this morning. You're scheduled for a short break, and I will take it. And I didn't... Okay, so it didn't score me for some reason. Okay, that's fine. I don't mind. Better that it didn't score me. I like... Actually, that's cool that they've given you an option where you don't even have to get scored. That's nice. I like that. So it isn't too intimidating. Does replay mean actually replay it? Oh, or an actual replay? That would be pretty cool if there was a replay. But I'm thinking that's just replay the actual scenario. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed that. That was the scenario that came with the Class 801. I'm not sure. People have been asking me, like, how do you get the, like, test track or whatever, H1. I don't even know about the test track yet. I haven't even been to it. I think that the test track is now linked with the trains... Academy, TS Academy or whatever, so I'm not sure how you get on it or whatever. I think you could still even use the old test track, so, you know, whatever. I hope you enjoyed the video of this Class 801 on the morning commute to Stevenage on the London to Peterborough ECML. Shouts for this video again were iScienceAlexP and Ozcan Ekici, if I'm saying that right. Their links and stuff will be down below. like and favorite the video if you want to, subscribe if you want to be kept up to date with my videos, like the my Facebook page if you're having problems with getting the subscription stuff. I post my videos and stuff like that on Facebook, and if you want to contact me on Facebook, that's good. Like, I respond to most messages and stuff you guys post to me on Facebook. And share it to your friends. That's one of the main things that helped me out. If you give it a share somewhere. And yeah, I've done my time. I'm Qwerty Afro. Hope you enjoyed this video. I'll be seeing you guys in another video or another Train Simulator 2015 video, whatever. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I've been Qwerty Afro. See you next time. Bye bye.